While the science of modern geology can explain many fascinating rock formations and how they formed, sometimes despite everything we know, us scientists occasionally encounter geologic formations that even with our best efforts can't be easily explained. The single formation that I believe best exemplifies this point can be found in the cold Siberian interior of Russia. There, far away from civilization, 23 kilometers west-northwest of the village of Movo, you can find a strange rocky crater in the densely forested landscape. Known as Patomskiy Crater, it consists of a raised cone which measures 170 meters or 558 feet long, 130 meters or 427 feet wide, and rises 39 meters or 128 feet above the surrounding landscape. Patomskiy Crater also has a defined outer and inner rim, the latter of which occurs alongside a tall dome structure within its 79-meter or 259-foot wide crater. But wait, I hear the geologists in my audience shout, this is clearly just an isolated cinder cone. While I must admit that Patomskiy Crater is similar in size to some smaller end cinder cones, there is one major problem with this theory. Cinder cones, for reference, are composed out of both ash and small ejected vesicular lava fragments termed cinders, often containing multiple million cubic meters of these igneous rock units. Patomskiy Crater, on the other hand, is not composed of any lava rocks or ash, or even igneous rocks of any kind. Instead, it is composed of 300,000 cubic meters of a 600 million-year-old sedimentary rock type known as limestone. And this exists alongside occasional fragments of sandstone and schist, which likely originated more than 500 meters below ground. So clearly, something must have happened to cause such a deep rock unit, even in minor amounts, to end up on the surface. While Patomskiy Crater has been frequently reported to have been discovered in 1949, the truth is that indigenous peoples to the region knew of it long beforehand. They discuss the area as full of evil spirits which should be avoided at all costs, which leads me to believe that after the crater formed, it somehow caused some form of harm when a person traversed the area to investigate, perhaps due to lingering gas emissions. While some models suggest the Patomskiy Crater formed in two events around 1450 and between 1841 and 1842, others suggest it formed in a single event around the year 1700. So, what are the existing hypotheses on how Patomskiy Crater formed? The first hypothesis that scientists came up with, and which we can immediately discount, suggests that a very dense iron meteorite struck the area and got buried 100 or 200 meters beneath the crater. This can be disproven by the fact that rocks underlying the crater are less, not more dense, a lack of magnetic anomalies, and the general fact that small-scale meteorite impacts do not form craters that look like Patomskiy Crater. The second hypothesis suggests that Patomskiy Crater is a mud volcano, but this also runs into a few obvious problems. Signs of mud and mud volcanism are nowhere to be found, and as one expert I asked told me, mud volcanoes don't tend to occur in isolation as they generally occur in clusters. And yet, Patomskiy Crater is truly an isolated feature. The third hypothesis is that Patomskiy Crater is actually a cryovolcano which formed via an explosion of natural gas released by thawing permafrost. While this theory is plausible, as it would explain the elevated levels of carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide found in the emplaced limestone, this doesn't seem to work because the permafrost is still continuous in this part of Russia today. The fourth hypothesis suggests that a hydrothermal explosion occurred here due to a drop in pressure on a natural and non-volcanic fault-related hot spring. The problem is, no evidence of a hot spring which could have triggered this has ever been found. Another possibility is that there were no explosions at Patomskiy Crater and that instead the crater was formed by the uplift of limestone related to one or more salt diapirs. The problem with this possibility is that no other similar features have been found nearby. Thus, we come back again to the idea that a volcanic eruption formed this feature, specifically a phreatic one which did not erupt any lava. While technically existing just outside of the Lake Baikal Rift, in my opinion, it exists in close enough proximity to this province that rift-related volcanism could theoretically occur here. It has been suggested that a deep carbonatite or phonolite magma chamber exists, which sent heated geothermal fluids enriched in rare earth elements to the surface, which then flashed to steam and exploded. Which of these ideas do you think is correct? Do you have a theory of your own? Be sure to let me know in the comments section below. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Farmer83, for supporting my work.